Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. So, my dear brother, today we are having this commemoration of Saint Saturninus. So, we have this beautiful passage from the Gospel and from the Epistle of St. Paul to Timothy. And the Gospel according to St. Matthew. So, you have here the very first line that we have in the Imitation of Christ. One who works in it is here in the verse of Alleluia, that's what I want to say, sorry. So, qui sequitur me non ambulat in tenebris, it says, Habebit lumen vitae eternae, one who follows me will not walk in darkness but will have light, eternal light. So, that is the thing that we need to keep before our mind all the time. We follow the truth, we follow our Lord Jesus Christ, so we don't have to fear. So this is the courage that martyrs have. So in spite of so many difficulties around them, so many persecutions, so talk about in the Gospel, and he talks about that. So in spite of persecution, St. Paul also talks about it. In spite of all these difficulties, they stood fast. They held on to the faith, the truth. So that is what should give us courage. In spite of many things that we may have to lose, we should not be afraid of that, what we will lose. They will kill us. They will cause damage to the material things that we have. But if we succeed in saving our soul, that is the victory. That is the victory of martyrs. They lost many things. They lost their relatives. They lost their friends. They lost all their reputation in many cases because of the false accusation. But in spite of all that, they kept the faith. They had the courage to give witness to Christ. So that is the victory of the martyrs. So that is what we should remember frequently when we are a bit low. We may say when we are depressed because people do this, people talk this about us, and so on. So not just on the spiritual thing that I am talking about, even the life that you live in this world, no? So many things that people talk about us, untruth, even they say about us. As long as we hold on to the truth and the faith, we should not be afraid. So the courage, the virtue of the courage, the fortitude is necessary. Remember, it is one of the gifts of the Holy Ghost, fortitude, to stand fast, not to lose heart because of so many people are against us, so many things goes against us. The people of this world will not understand that. That's why they always inclined towards the majority, because they don't want to be left out. So they want to go to, so to speak, the safer side, which is the where they find big crowd, big numbers. But our safety, our protection, our refuge is our Lord Jesus Christ, the truth. As long as we walk in the truth, we should not be fearing anything. So there's a very, very beginning of the Imitation of Christ is like that. As long as we walk in the light, that is following our Lord Jesus Christ, we will not be afraid. We will have that eternal life in us. So let us remember that whenever we celebrate the Feast of a Martyr or commemorate the martyrdom of any saint, let us remember that they held on to the truth, and they kind of despise their own life. That's another aspect of it. The positive thing is that they hold on to the truth, to our Lord Jesus Christ. The negative thing is negative in the sense like whatever they lose, they even lost their life, lost all their properties, all the possessions of this world. But they held on to the great treasure, which is the faith, faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. So let us ask the same courage to hold on to our faith, what we have received. St. Paul says, I passed on what I have received. So we have received through our forefathers the gift of faith. So let us preserve that until the end, in our honor and the blessing of God.